ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to welcome our clients and express special gratitude to many of you who have supported us during the past 4 months, during our revolution and the following invasion of our country by Russia. Please believe me that during this difficult period, any external support was very important and greatly appreciated. And I also appreciate that so many of you have come here. I understand that for some it has been difficult to persuade your compliance or security officer, and we have had even some clients who have been traveling here since 97, and they have been persuaded by their wife to stay at home this time. It has taken 3 revolutions, each tougher than the previous one, but the result is that Ukraine's population and leadership are now firmly united around European values and our path to freedom, democracy, rule of law and free market economy is quite firm. The changes unfortunately happened at extreme loss of life. More than 100 people have been killed and many thousands still remain injured. But the fight has united our society around common goals and created an environment of zero tolerance to corruption, lack of rule of law, abuse of power. I am glad we have Prime Minister Yatsenyuk with us today, as well as a strong representation of his government. We have Ministers of Economy, Energy, Cabinet of Ministers, Deputy Minister of Finance, heads of tax and customs authorities, the governor of the National Bank, and the CEO of Naftogaz. We will also hear from the most popular contender in the ongoing presidential race, Petro Alexeyevich Poroshenko, and GFK will present to us today their most recent poll, which was completed just yesterday and has not been published yet. Furthermore, we have managements of 25 local companies that have raised debt or equity in international markets and plan to do more in the future. They all share their plans on how to deal with the political and economic change that has taken place in Ukraine. On this note, I would like to introduce the Prime Minister. Arseniy Petrovich has done an excellent job on many fronts in only a month's time. He has created a largely professional team drawing on people with clean track records, not only from politics, but also from business. He has taken control of a very difficult fiscal situation, finalized negotiations on a standby agreement with the IMF, signed the political part of the association agreement with the European Union. This all in an environment which has been very challenging. Large part of the past administration emigrated without passing over their portfolios. And our big brother, as we learned to call Russia in the Soviet days, us Eastern Europeans, has invaded Ukraine and used any mean to destabilize and pressure Ukraine. We should also not forget that a month ago the constitution has been changed to a parliamentary republic and a new presidential election has been called. Now that we are on a good track to macroeconomic stabilization, it would be interesting to hear from the Prime Minister about the reforms we should expect to ease doing business and the role models we will follow on that path, whether it will be some of the successful Eastern European countries like the Baltics or Slovakia, Poland, or Singapore, Hong Kong, or any other role models that you are looking at. Arseniy Petrovich, you have in front of you about 130 international investors, mainly from Europe and North America, and about 100 local investors and representatives of managements of 25 companies who have raised, as I said, debt and equity in international markets, and plan to do more, hopefully later this year, when the yields on sovereign debt decline further and markets reopen for Ukraine and its banks and corporations. Prime Minister, I would like to assure you that all investors I have spoken with are very supportive of your actions and plan to invest billions of dollars of private capital as long as they will be treated in accordance with law. Ukraine and your government have the opportunity to build a clean track record by standing up to its obligations. in what everybody understands is a very difficult period, and as a result be rewarded by the ability to return to international markets to fund public and private sector, privatize or IPO, state-owned companies, and attract FDI already this year. Several of the large investors have offered to share their advice with you at your convenience. And last but not least, after Prime Minister's speech, there will be opportunity to ask several questions, so please get ready. Don't be shy to come up with difficult questions. Whenever I have been on the plane, on the same plane with the Prime Minister, he has been reading Financial Times from start to finish, so he understands our business better than you may think.